Once you have downloaded the Lock and Load app, you can take a tour to get some tips on how to use the app. You can also sign up to Lock and Load, or you can log in if you have an existing Lock and Load account. Log in using the exact same details that you used when you set up your Lock and Load account from the website. For example, your mobile number and password. Tick Remember Me to make logging in easy, and click here if you've lost your password. When you open the Lock and Load app, this is the first screen that you come to. It's here that you can take your photos, make audio notes, and make general notes. You can take up to 10 photos at a time. And there are some handy arrows that you can draw on your photos just by swiping your finger across the screen. You can either make audio notes by speaking into the app, or you can select a pre-recorded audio note in your phone. Also, remember to click here, the menu, if you ever want to get to the menu on the Lock and Load app. From the menu, you can access all of your functions on the Lock and Load app. This is the menu page of the Lock and Load app. You can get access to all of the Lock and Load functions from here. Just click on the relevant tab. From the menu, click on Add Job to create a new job file and fill in the details. From the menu, click on Job List to view a list of all the jobs that you have in Lock and Load. Click on the relevant job file to access functions for that specific job. From the menu, click on Record of Work to see a list of all the ROW documents in Lock and Load. Click Add to fill out a new Record of Work document. Choose Relevant Job File and add reference notes if needed. Click Add Record to add a new Record of Work document. Fill this out as needed. Select Restricted Work in the drop-down list and make your other selections, and then click Submit. From the menu, click on Health and Safety. Here, you can see a list of the health and safety records that you have in Lock and Load. Just click Add to create a new health and safety record. From the Lock and Load app, you can fill out 3 of the health and safety worksheets. They are Toolbox Safety Meetings, Accident Incident Register, and Induction. Just click on the relevant tab to access the required worksheet. You fill out the worksheets as needed, either selecting from the drop-down lists or adding new information if it's needed. You also have the ability from the Lock and Load app to obtain electronic signatures. When you click Add Attending, you can get the people attending your toolbox meeting or inductions to electronically sign in. You can add the person's name, take a photo, and get them to sign. Then click Submit. Fill in the rest of the worksheet as needed. Fill out the other health and safety worksheets in a similar way. Some tabs that you click on will open up additional screens so that you can fill out your information in greater detail. From the menu, click on Staff Training Record. Here, you'll see a list of the existing records that you've got in Lock and Load. Click Add to add in a new staff training record. Fill in as needed. Select the hazard. Fill in the other information and add more information if it's needed. From the menu, click on Timesheets. Here, you can see a list of existing timesheet entries. Click Add to add in a new timesheet. Click on the drop-down box to find the relevant job, and then click Start. The Lock and Load app will pick up the date and time for you. Just make notes if you need to, and click Save. You also have the ability to put in lunchtime, and you also can make annual or sick leave entries. When you finish for the day, click End Time and Save. From the menu, click on Web Page. From here, you can edit your web page profile. Click here to add photos and text to your web page. This list shows the categories that have been created to organize and display photos and text. To add a new category, click Add. Otherwise, click on an existing category to add photos and text to it. Within this category, Commercial, you can see the list of photos that already exists there. To add another photo, click Add. You can either add an existing photo from your gallery, or there's the option of taking a new photo. Once you are happy with the photo and text, click Submit.